RemoteFiringSystems.com will be stocking the RFRemotech MB32Q programmable firing system. Included with the MB32Q is the module itself, a plastic case, have a manual 200 meter remote. It has backlighting, on-off switch, battery door, 12-volt A23 battery. This is the stepper and the program start remote. It has a stepper function and step through the cues. And it also has buttons that can start a program that is entered into the module. It can pause that program, it can continue a paused program, and it can totally stop a stepper function or the program function. It can lock and unlock the keys. It has an on-off switch, 200 meter remote. Battery in the back, 12-volt A23. Comes with the firing system antenna. Comes with the software. There's instructions, the melody combiner software, the scripting software. Comes with a set of keys and the external battery jumper. Comes with a USB cable so you can go from your computer to the module and load a script from the computer into the module, or vice versa. If you have a script in the module itself and you want to put it on the computer, you can do that also. For some reason they sent a battery charger. I asked what it is for, and they said it's to charge rechargeable AA nickel metal hydride batteries that can be placed in behind the battery door. Here's the battery door. Where you would place the batteries if you wanted to put nickel metal hydride batteries. I don't know if it works. I'm not going to even try testing it. Seems like a waste of money to spend that kind of money on rechargeable batteries when you could have a decent external power source for the same price. Let's look at what comes with the MB32Q. We'll start with the keys. Comes with two keys. Please, when you receive your system, take one of them off, put it in a safe place, leave one with the system. You get people that lose both because they leave the keys together. Comes with a shorter 433 megahertz antenna. If purchasing the MB32Q, has the same SMA connector on the side as the Sparkfire. You could use a Sparkfire antenna, which is also 433 megahertz. It can be found on RemoteFiringSystems.com. And also the 30-inch antenna extension wire can be used. So you would screw one end into the receptacle on the firing module. And the antenna, whether it's this one or the upgraded Sparkfire antenna, can be placed on the L-bracket. The L-bracket taped up in the air on, if you're in the ground, something non-metallic, on concrete, whatever you're going to would use to hold it up in the air on concrete, but just make sure it's non-metallic. I use fiberglass rods in the ground. Or if I'm on concrete, I drill a hole in a 2x6 and then place my fiberglass rod in the hole that I made in the 2x6. That would help get the firing system up off the ground and up in the air where it belongs for better reception. For now, we'll put it on the firing system. Okay, power sources. The MB32Q has a removable door with four screws on the back, and underneath is a place for 10 AA batteries. They fit really tight. I found that you pretty much have to take a small screwdriver and pry the plastic away on the positive side to get them in place. Otherwise you're really going to fight it trying to get them in there. So that's the trick, is to just pry a little bit on away so that they can be installed. Use a good battery like a Energizer Industrial or a Duracell Procell, I believe they're called. Don't use Dollar General cheap batteries. With the AA batteries, a person can ignite two clip igniters per Q. That'd be the Talon clip igniters, or three regular E-matches in parallel. Probably six E-matches in series. I don't really know about the MJ initiators. I would have to believe it'd be similar to the clip igniters. I'm not really sure on those. I haven't tested them very much. With AA batteries anyway. So that'd be your weakest choice, and anybody that knows me knows that I would never personally use a AA battery power source. Like the other RF RemoTech systems, there's the available external power source receptacle. Can be hooked 12 to 24 volts externally with the jumper provided with the system. So right now we're hooked to a 12 volt battery. The firing system chooses the power source with more voltage. So in the case of this system right now, there is 15 volts. That's because the internal power source has more voltage than the external power source that I hooked up. You'd actually have to take out the AA batteries to use this 12 volt external power source. Battery like I just had hooked up would be good for up to six clip igniters per Q, six relay matches in parallel, six clip igniters in parallel, probably a dozen E-matches in series. This is a tool battery, 19.2 diehard. You would have to use a voltmeter to find which of these terminals are positive and negatives. I know on this battery that this is negative and that this is positive, and when it's properly hooked polarity wise, this battery is showing 19.9 volts. So right now we are running on the external power source and not the internal power source. Typically batteries from tools are above 2 Ah and should be comparable to using the 12 volt sealed lead acid battery I hooked earlier, as far as the capabilities of firing. Okay, on the module itself, there is the program, which would be the off position. There's the test and the arm modes. So key on, to program this module to a remote, we would have it in the middle off program position. There's a couple ways to program a module to the remote. One would be to just hit the shift key until you see on the screen it says press any button on the remote. turn a remote on. It says code exists. Let's clear all codes out first. We would hit the enter button until we see the screen come up. We're going to go to number 5, which is clear codes of transmitters, and hit enter. Now it says all codes are cleared. We're just going to get out of this, and we'll just hit shift again, and we'll hit a button on the transmitter, and it says successful. We can do that again for the manual. Hit any button and it says learn successful. So that'd be one way. And the second option is to go into the program menu. We're going to clear all codes again. It says codes cleared, and we're going to go to number 4, which is learn codes, and hit enter, and then push a button on the remote. Oops, gotta choose it. We learn the manual one, push it again. All right, so we've put both of these into it. So this module will now respond to a button push of these two remotes. Okay, so before the show, we would have the module off. We would load our igniters into the queue. I just have a couple of light bulbs in here right now so that I can show you continuity check. Turn the key on. We put it in the test function, and in the test function you see there's a green and a red light. When there's continuity, the red goes out and the green is brighter. And with the empty queue or a igniter with no continuity, both lights are on, showing no continuity of that queue. I test every igniter I put in parallel separately before I twist them together and put it in a queue. I sell a continuity tester on my website just for that purpose. Okay, so before the show, the key would go on. We put it in R mode. Grab the manual remote, turn it on, make sure we have a fresh battery in. The remote should be used straight up with the antenna up. The higher you get the antenna up off the ground, the better off you are, so that the receiver can receive the signal. So in theory, it would, if you were squatting on the ground, or this was 2 foot off the ground in a chair, could possibly have worse reception at the receiver than if you were standing up with this 5 or 6 foot in the air. So we'll choose a group or a bank with A. So right now, bank A is active. It will stay active until another bank is chosen or you turn the firing system off. Push 1. Whoops, that was 3. Push 1, their queue on time is 0.60 seconds. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Always fun working around a camera. Okay, so now we activated B. We go through, we can do 1 through 8. Activate bank C. Go 1 through 8, bank D, and go 1 through 8, and that's how you would manually use the MB32Q. Now you can program as many of these units as you want to the same remote. Say you wanted 3 units 50 foot apart, you could do that. You would just program all 3 to this remote, set them up at their own location, and when you push a button on the remote, all three firing systems would respond. The second way would be to say have two different remotes and two different firing systems. You would have each one on its own remote and for 64 individual cues. Let's move on to the stepper function. We would do the same thing. We would load the firing system up with the igniters, turn the system on, use its test function to make sure there's continuity on the cues. And before the show, we would turn the system on, put it in arm mode, and we can use the stepper button, and we can use the stop button, and we can use the lock unlock button. Okay, right now I locked it, the light's off, unlock. Right now the red's on, so we have not used a push to cue yet. When we push the first cue, you see it goes to a green state on the remote. Q2 with the second button press, 3, 4, 5. We just go through all 32 cues. If we did push stop, see the light went red, we would start back at QA1. So it's a simple way to step through with one button. And next I'm going to show you the program function on the remote. So inside of this module I just have a simple 0.6 second simple sequence. It'll just go through each cue at every 0.6 second intervals. So we're not sitting here for minutes looking at red LEDs come on. The same thing, the afternoon of the show and we're setting up, we turn the key on after placing igniters in the cues and put it in its test function to see continuity. And before the show, turn the key on, put it in arm mode, switch on, antenna up, straight in the air. When we push the start button, you see the sequence stop or start, and we can, I'll show you the pause and the continue buttons. So we'll start the program, we'll pause the program, we'll continue the program. Again, if something were to happen, something starts on fire and you needed to stop your show, you can do that right now. If everything out in the field was on this one remote, it would pause everything, go take care of what you needed to, and we can just simply continue from where we left off. So really the only time that you would actually push stop would be if you just needed to start over. It would be start, pause, or continue during the show. This could be, you know, this could be your whole show. It could be a 30-minute show off of this module. Just a nice little single position show. You would just program in, which I'll show in other videos, and just hit the start. So that's the basics of the MB32Q kit as it comes. I'm not going to try to talk about everything in one video. There's just so much to cover about the MB32Q, so keep checking back for more videos on how to program the MB32Q, both on the screen itself and using the software that is provided, hooking the cable into the USB port and into a computer to load a script into the MB32Q.